Hi everybody, this is Alexandra in Zombieland, and I'm here to talk about one of my favorite things, which is zombies. Everybody loves zombies, right? Right? I do. So you better love zombies too. Because otherwise, I don't know why you're watching my channel. Because it's a lot about zombies. So I put together a tutorial for you, and this is all about how to do airbrush zombie paint. So any of your own 3D effects you want to put underneath this look would work really well. This is more about the paint scheme that's really effective for especially doing a lot of zombies at once. Because if you have a few different airbrush artists, you can just literally go down the line of people, make an assembly line. Also, if you noticed, I am wearing a zombie-inspired beauty makeup today. And I will be doing a tutorial on that in the near future, for keep your eyes out for that. And keep your eyes out for other types of cool tutorials. Also, don't forget that my web series will be coming up this fall, which is the full story of Alexandria in Zombieland. It's basically a retelling of Alice in Wonderland, except a little darker, grosser, and there will be zombies, for sure. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy. First, I start with stippling a layer of latex onto my model, and as you can see, after the latex is dried, I start tugging at it, ripping the latex, creating holes in the skin. This looks like rotting or dead flesh, could be cuts. I warn my model to hold their breath as I'm painting them with the airbrush, and I tell them to raise their hand in case they need to breathe. First, I start paling out my model using a yellowish white tint that I mixed. All my airbrush makeup is acrylic paint that's watered down. So as you can see here, I'm doing a misting of white all over and then using a lot of extra white on the highlights. I'm using a burnt umber as my contour. As you can see, I do a little bit under the cheekbones, temples, especially adding a lot of depth around the collarbone. This is really good for a zombie effect, since zombies tend to have the collarbones stick out really good. Then I take the brown and I do dead liver spots all over the body, and it also helps break up all the paling that I've done, and especially adding depth into where the latex is. Contouring to the hands. A little bit of contouring goes a long way with making fingers and hands look bonier. And then I always like to add brown around the knuckles. It really helps sell that dead feeling, I think. Next, I add purple. This is my bruise color. I use it for contouring a little bit, but also I do a lot of spotting with it, which really helps break up the skin even more and is great for little bruise spots. Kind of imagine if you're dead, dying, your blood's kind of bursting, and your body's just decaying. So you get pale and you see the blood on the surface a lot. And then I also do my first layer of veining with the purple. I do really spidery looking veins, a lot of X style veins that cross over each other, really squiggly lines. Really good, again, for breaking up the skin. It's really good for creating that first layer of webbing and veins. Makes it look like blood vessels are breaking throughout the body. Really good effect for zombies. I do some purple lines around the face too. And then I do the same technique with a pale blue. With the pale blue, it stands out a little bit more, so I've had to do a little bit more precise, really good emphasis veining. All these little details, all these little layers really help break up the skin, really give you a realistic color of skin. If you paint someone one color, they're just not like they're painted. With layering up your color, you can start to see it almost just feels like it's blending into the skin. It feels natural. Next, I take my white again and I blend all of those under layers of skin essentially that we've just painted. I've used the white to make a top layer of skin,
which really blends and merges everything together. It's amazing how important this is for zombies. I go a little bit heavier on the highlight spots again. We're really just trying to do breakup, little splotches, a little splatter, and just really blend in and give it a whole top layer of skin. Next, I take my eyeshadow and I start putting red eyeshadow below the eyes, making him look more sick, obviously, and infected. Red eyeshadow is great for around the eyes because the problem with using an airbrush near the eyes is that people don't like getting air sprayed on their face really at all, and especially not on the eyes. It's very uncomfortable if you're a model, and since your eyes move around so much, paint can chip there, so it's good to use powder. And powder is a really good blend anyway, so I really prefer using powder. I take the dark purple and I'm doing under his eyes, giving his eyes a good sunken feeling and making his bags pop out more where the red is. Then I start adding blood. I first go in, I have rotting parts of the zombie flesh. Adding a little bit of blood around under the under eyes to kind of give it, once again, that bleeding, blood, infected feeling. Taking advantage of that big piece of latex on the side of the cheek, creating a really deep cut. Surprising what just a little bit of blood can do as far as fake wounds and cuts. I'm taking a stipple sponge with that blood and getting more of a splatter blood effect. Help to blend in the sore spots I had before. Just adding decorative flicks of blood all around him because zombies eat flesh and it's covered in blood. He likes the blood, obviously. Now I start coloring the teeth. Plain white teeth can really take you out of makeup, especially something a character or a monster like a zombie. So I add a layer of yellow to stain them, and then adding black to make their gums look infected. Really good for zombies or other kind of monsters. Just makes the mouth look a lot grosser and scarier. And then, of course, the blood around the mouth. Because zombies gotta eat, right? And what are they like? Flesh and brains. Your models are really good sport too. It's great to make blood that is edible. And as you can see, our zombie is ready to